Get Ken to kick off an old tune called Simon Crutchfield we'd like to do for you.
Cabin floor.
just like it reads today on cobblestone. Mary Crutchfield, here lies Mary Crutchfield. She betrayed the love that Simon gave. Riley Harper, if the devil is to blame, why can't you ride past Simon Crutchfield's grave?
He's a pretty good singer, ain't he?
You bet.
But now, he can sing good, but he don't know a thing about cutting off a dog's tail, Charlie.
Off a dog's tail.
The other day, I went over to his house, and I heard a dog out behind the smokehouse just hollering and take it on. I went out there to see what was happening, you know. Oh, Ed is out there cutting his dog's tail off, Charlie.
You don't mean.
Yeah, he cut off about that much, and that dog would holler and take on. He cut off about that much more, and it'd just start all over again.
I guess so.
I said, Eddie, if you're going to cut that dog's tail off, why in the world don't you just cut it off at once and get it over with? He said, John, the ways he's taking on over just a little bitty piece, I don't believe he could stand it if I cut it all off at once. You think we'd get old Jeff to do a little banjo picking first?
I've been wanting to hear something.
I am too. Let's turn him loose.
Send him a soldier's job.
Best in the country, Mr. Ken Byrd.
Thank you.
post office seen and they said they had a package for you.
Look, Sheriff, I got a package to see.
John, he dropped that on purpose. What's
that? He broke it, Charlie.
Yeah, I know what you think. You think I'm just mad at you.
It's leaking, Charlie. It's all going to run out if you don't catch some of it.
That?
I don't know. Taste it and see.
Oh, it's homebrew, but it's warm. It must have been in the mail.
Well, it's been in the shipping for 2 or 3 days, but it ain't homebrew. It's better than that. It's good, ain't it, you?
Well.
Taste, get you a pretty good deal. Get it, but it's going to all run out before you get in it.
Well,
there you go.
Maybe you can save some of it.
That's sarsaparilla. Wait a minute. That's sarsaparilla.
I'll bet you're all wrong.
I'm going to look and see for myself what it is. You don't know what it is. It's a,
it's a little puppy. And I thought he broke it. I gotta put him up while the Colonel fiddles a tune for us.
Don't you weep no more. times are past and gone. All the good times are o'er. All the good times are past and gone. Little darling, don't you weep no more.
I want to sing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, she won't sing so bad. I had an old dog, her name was Blue. You bet she went around her too. Blue, blue, oh, blue. Every night she got dark, oh, blue, she began to bark. Blue, blue, oh, blue. I went to see what old Blue tree, wait till parson up 7-3. Blue, blue, oh, blue. Got the act and I cut it down. You bet Blue went around and around. Blue, blue, oh, blue. Blue got sick and about to die. Gone her knee, begin to cry. Blue, blue, oh, blue. Oh, Blue died, she died so hard. Chuck up thing in my backyard. Blue, blue, oh, blue.
Tell you something about that dog. That's the third dog that he's trained to do that. And this dog, on his first song, he's been using Old Blue for his first song. But I think that dog watches for that bear. Is that right, Neal?
Yeah.
And so what Neil's done, he's changed around to where the second song's about Old Blue. And I'll tell you, she's got where she really likes to bark with you, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does. You know I can't sing. You want to help me?
Neal Crow, he's a legend really in his own time here in Ozarks, and Mrs. Crow and Spring Wheel, if you've not talked to them, well, please do. They've been a part of this theater since 1968. Now, here's the thing about it. They're the only ones that have this record. They have never missed a show, and this is their 18th year.
Spinning wheel.
Would you like me to go ahead and rest, John?
2 hours ago.
2 hours ago. What about now? John, come here. Come here.
What's going on?
I'll tell you what, dude. You just go ahead and take that gourd and put it up. You're under
arrest. Oh, no. We're going to do a train song before we get out of here.
What with?
Well, this is a musical instrument.
That's a birdhouse.
It's a lot like Wetter Brown's head. There ain't nothing in there. We're going to do a train song. We'll get old Charlie and Eddie to furnish the steam. Get the colonel to ring the bell. I'm going to be the engineer, and you can blow the whistle.
Well, good.
Well, you left me out. I want to do something real important.
Winter, when we get to rolling pretty good, you get out there summers on the track and flag the traffic.
Harm, if you's my husband, I'd put poison in your teeth.
Yeah, if I's your husband, I'd...
Thank you.
Show you how you play it. See, you play it with your mouth.
Boy, you got the thing to play it with.
You have to tune this thing, Colonel. Charles Joe, give me a D chord.
Pretty close, Sheriff, but it needs to come up.
Just a hair. Now, to tune it, you can turn that little knob that's all there is to it.
What's the matter, Sheriff?
That goose has been up here on that porch.
Oh, get the broom, boy. Boy, he can get in the morning, anybody I ever seen, Colonel. I'll bet you one thing, though, that'll teach him to do the barnyard shuffle.
All right, John. What's the barnyard shuffle?
Oh, you know what the barnyard shuffle is, Sheriff. It works, too.
That's what I'm talking about, see? That if he got in a battle of wits with somebody, he'd be totally unarmed, wouldn't he? Let's see here. Sound all right? Let's do that old song, 8th of January. You want to? Some of you may know this is the Battle of New Orleans, but it came from an old fiddle tune, the 8th of January.
Johnny, you noticed how he done that, boy. He is disciplined and all of that. Ain't that the word, you know, when you're acting good?
I don't know what that means.
Well, he learned that, whatever that word is. He learned it in the Army.
He learned it in the Army.
Yeah, he was in the Army 13 years. He's going to make a career out of it, but he got something bad the matter with him, and they had to send him home. They liked to never figured out what it was.
Well, what was it?
Well,
John?
Finally they said, "Sergeant Hidebound, you've got the furniture disease."
The
now,
furniture
John,
disease.
That's what,
do you want to talk like that for? I just stepped back in the cabin to get a drink of water, and here you start telling something else. There's not any such thing as the furniture disease, and the Army wouldn't let you out for it. What's the furniture disease?
That's when the chest falls down in the drawers.
I want to borrow the widow here for a minute. We want to do an old song that was written back in the early 1800s that the sheriff actually got from a gentleman up in Mountain View by the name of Bob Blair. We've got some folks from Mountain View here tonight, so I thought I might mention that. In the shady day, down by a flowing stream, confusion. Let's all get together and do the old wreck of the old 97. When you hit, kick that off for us, John.
They gave him his orders, Monroe, Virginia, saying, "Steve, you're way behind time. This is about 38, but it's old 97. You must put her in dispenser all the time." Then he turned around and said to his wife, shovel on a little bore coal. And when we cross them wide old mountains, you can watch old 97 roll. But it's old 97, you must put a red to spend your own time.
Play it, Bob.
They was going down the grade, making 90 miles an hour when his whistle began to scream. He was found in a wreck, put his hand on the throttle and was scalded to death by the steam. Now, ladies, you must take warning from this time on and learn. Never speak harsh words to your true loving husband. He may leave you and never return.
Thank you. Bill?
Yeah.
How you doing, boy?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good. I'm getting better now.
Well, I noticed you've had a broke arm. You got, Bill, what happened to your arm?
Well, my wife was cleaning out the clothes closet the other day, and she threw out a pair of shoes out there.
Threw out a pair of shoes out of clothes. Well, how'd that break your arm?
Well, I was still in them.
What are you going to play for us
now? I'm
going to
play a little bit of that Red Wing.
He's the only one-armed harmonica player we've ever had here.
Thank you.
Listen, Paul, them bears are backing them hog pens. I'm going to get my gun and run down
there. Gun, you be careful. That gun, you going to kill
me. I'll be right back. Don't nobody leave now. I'll be right back.
Courage, you're out there. Water.
We're going to do a song that we always include on the Arkansas Traveler Show. It's called Down in Arkansas. You want to tell them how that goes where they might sing along with us, sir?
It says, bloop. Down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas. The sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas.
So y'all join in and help us. Down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas. Sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas. Down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas. Sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas. Had a cow that slobbered bad down in Arkansas. Took her to my great-granddad down in Arkansas. Asked him what to do for it down in Arkansas. He said, teach that cow to spit down in Arkansas. Down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas. Sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas. Down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas, down in the Arkansas. Sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas. Thank you. Arkansas. Ma got married to my dad down in Arkansas. Grandpa got mad and he cussed a while down in Arkansas. The grandma said it's the latest style down in Arkansas. Down in the Arkin, down in the Arkin, down in the Arkansas. Sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas. Down in the Arkin, down in the Arkin, down in the Arkansas. Sweetest girl I ever saw was down in the Arkansas.
Hey, there's a bear over here.
Get it, Ed.
Get it. John, I've stole Billy Joe's guitar over here.
Yes, that's, sir.
It's much better than that thing
it's
over there. I may just keep
Martin
it.
Tubb. Well, you got a Martin Tubb, and
yeah.
He's got a Gibson
yeah.
guitar, ain't he?
Here's a little old kind of a story song about a family, and it's called The Mixed Up Family. And it goes like this. It's about a girl who was getting up close to marrying age, and she found a fella she wanted to marry. And so she went to her daddy and she sang a little song to him like this.
Father, oh dear father, get off your lazy bones. Tomorrow I will marry my sweet Billy Jones. Daughter, oh dear daughter, you'll have to find another. Cannot marry Billy Jones, for he is your half-brother.
So this kind of aggravated her, but it wasn't long till a friend of hers came by, and she said, don't worry about it. We'll go to hunting around here, and we'll find you another feller. And so sure enough, they did, and she went back to her daddy, and she sang this little song.
Father, oh dear father, I hope you do not frown. Tomorrow I will marry my sweet Jimmy Brown. Daughter, oh dear daughter, you'll have to find another. You cannot marry Jimmy Brown, for he is your half-brother.
So this time she just swore that she was never going to have anything to do with men again. She was just going to forget about it. But it wasn't long till that same friend came by, and she said, I tell you what we'll do. Bright and early in the morning, we'll saddle up her mules, and we'll ride over the mountains into the valley over there where your old pappy had never been. And we'll find you another feller. And so that's what they did, and she came back to her daddy, and she sang this little song.
Father, oh dear father, I hope you do not care. Tomorrow I will marry my sweet John O'Dare. Daughter, oh dear daughter, you'll have to find another. You cannot marry John O'Dare, for he is your half-brother.
And so she decided that she was going to go talk to her mother about this, and so she went to her mother, and she sang this little song.
Mother, oh dear mother, my heart is undone. Every boy I love turns out to be my father's son.
So the old woman looked across the room at the old man. He was sitting over there whittling out an axe handle, and she knew what was going on because she knew what a big liar the old man was. She had been living with him for about 30 years. So she took her a dip of snuff, and she turned to her daughter, and she sang this little song.
Daughter, oh dear daughter, vows. It ain't no sin, 'cause you ain't no kin to your pappy anyhow.